Ah, good morning. I realized something today when I was looking through the microscope at the organisms in the mud puddle. When I'm looking through the microscope, I'm also looking at myself. It's a kind of meditation. And I react to the things that I see as a human being with all my built-in biases. One of the things that I probably shouldn't be seeing, but I do see because of my built-in biases, is the concept of purpose. For me, the diatoms and the cyanobacteria and all those organisms that have chlorophyll in them and manufacture food from light and don't seem to have a real purpose in life, they're less interesting. Even though they're beautiful and they have a kind of mystique, but they're less interesting. The ones that appeal to me most, of course, are the large ciliates, who have appears to me, and I know it's nonsense, but what appears to me as a human being as a life of purpose, where they have to go out and find their way and find food and hunt and kill each other and that stuff that human beings are familiar with. And some of those creatures that I found very few ciliates, big, large ciliates in my sample today. I got frustrated. But I noticed that there are some really, really, really tiny creatures in there. We sort of ignore them, but I see them as, they don't have anything, the small ones, they struggle. I see struggle, even though I might not really, it might not really be there, but I see it. I see the struggle for those little creatures to find food and they kind of have the appearance of a purpose of sort of life. And so I thought I'd focus a little bit on them. There are some really, really tiny ones. Some that are barely visible under the microscope, but they do have they move quickly through the water, and they seem to have a direction and a purpose and a need, like me. Take a look.